Have you been writing code for some time now, but still find that your code is kinda hard to maintain and honestly ugly? Or maybe you are a new pipeline TD and you just come to the realization that your studio implements code reviews and you don't want to look bad. Well, in today's video, we are gonna do 7 easy Python tips that if you implement it, will level up your game. Hi, I'm Nelson. If you're new to this channel, I am a VFX technical director and I help other computer graphics VFX practitioners to basically create more, earn more, and live more. I share lots of tips and tricks, tutorials, industry insights, and all kinds of gear reviews on this channel to help you. Hit the like, dislike button, subscribe, and hit the bell if you're excited to step up your scripting game. I've been a software engineer and a pipeline technical director in the CG industry for over a decade. After years of mentoring other artists, pipeline TDs, and students to code, these are tips I find myself repeating all the time. And students give me so much feedback about how game-changing these tips are to their Python skills. And you know what's best? These tips are so easy to implement. We're not talking about test-driven development, unit testing, all of that stuff. These are easy to implement tips that you can do right now today. So let's jump right in and go to our first tip. Tip number one, follow the PEP8 style guide. The first thing you need to understand is code is read more often than it is written. And this is a fundamental principle that you need to keep in mind. If you're just learning Python, it's absolutely great to follow and learn the style guide. You will meet more Python code that adheres to the PEP8 style guide than the ones that don't. So it is imperative that you familiarize yourself with that and maybe even adopt that as your style guide. Now to help yourself do that, use a linter. PyLinter is a great linter that I highly recommend. You can find that as a plugin in PyCharm. You can also find that as a plugin in Sublime. So whatever integrated development environment or text editor you use, make sure it's an editor that will allow you to use a Python linter. The Python linter is the number one thing that's going to help you adhere to the style guide, because it is always pointing out to you areas where you are not adhering to the style guide. And so very quickly, it trains your muscles, it trains your hands, it trains you to know what to look for in order to adhere to the PEP8 style guide. So highly recommended, great tip, use a Python linter. Tip number two, intuitive but concise names. Take the time to name, rename your variable names, function names, class names, module names, everything, so that they are as intuitive and as easy to understand as possible. Your variable and function names should feel like you're reading plain English, which means variable names like A, B, C, X, Y, Z, those are a big no-no. Don't be afraid to refactor and rename as your code changes. As you develop your code, you're going to understand it better, and hence you're going to be able to name your variables and functions better. If you're interested in the details for the tips that I just shared with you, check out the book Clean Code by Robert C. Martin. It's an exceptionally good book that I recommend anyone who codes scripts to actually read. I'll include a link to the book in the description below, so make sure to check it out. Tip number three, use the Python property decorator. I often see code with a lot of get and set functions, like get radius, set height, and all of these come from a traditional maybe Java or C background where we use a get or set function in order to change or access values in a property of a class. However, in Python, you can always access the properties of a class simply by using the dot notation, by going object.property. So you could say circle.radius. If you find that you are going to need to do some sort of processing on your property, use the Python property decorator. The Python property decorator will allow you to do some sort of processing to your data before you assign it to your properties, such as maybe receiving a string as a path to a file, but then creating a path object out of that string and assigning that path object into your private property. You'll find that if you use the dot notation for Python properties, as well as the property decorator, your code will be free of gets and sets, which makes it so much cleaner and easier to read. Tip number 4, keep your function lines short and your arguments minimal. Long functions tend to do more than one thing and are difficult to read. If you find your function lines are too long, you probably need to break them down. I recommend less than 10 to 15 lines of code per function. For function arguments, 1 to 2 is pretty good. 3 is a stretch. Anything above 3 just makes the function really hard to use. If you find that you need to pass more than 3 arguments into a function, it's probably time to think about refactoring your arguments into a single object or a dictionary. Getting some useful tips so far in this video? Hit the subscribe button and smash that bell to get notified when more videos like these drop. Tip number 5, write comments that explain the why, but not the how. It may surprise you, but except for docstrings, I hardly write comments. Beginner mistake number 1, too much comments explaining what the code is doing. It may seem counterintuitive, but your code should be so simple and well-named that it explains itself. If you've been following the tips above in naming your variables well and keeping your functions short, then you really don't need to write much comments. Writing comments to explain how the code works violates the do not repeat yourself principle or DRY principle. It makes it hard to maintain your documentation and your comments when your code changes, and your code is going to change constantly. Starting with pseudocode that lays down how your code is going to work before writing a single line of code is a great practice, but remove your pseudocode when you are done. I tend to write comments to explain the reason why I am doing something to the user if they don't have specific domain knowledge, such as, I'm doing A, B, C in this order because Maya requires me to perform these steps in this exact order. Tip number 6, practice. It's easier to ask for forgiveness than permission. A classic example where EAFP works really well is when we need to save a file or open a file. A lot of beginner Python programmers adopt LBYL, or look before you leap. So what they would do is they would go ahead and check if the folder exists, if the file exists, before they would open a file or before they would write to a folder. Now that tends to open your code to a race condition. That means after you've checked that the file exists and before your next line in which you try to open the file, some process or some user over the network might have just deleted the file. In which case, when you try to open the file, it would fail, even though in your previous line, you'd already checked that the file exists. So now you can see why look before you leap isn't necessarily that great. Instead, the Python way is to just go ahead and open the file. And if it fails, it will throw you an error, which you can then use a try except statement to handle. That is a more explicit way to code. It eliminates the race condition, there are less repetitions, and in general, your code is easier to read. Tip number 7, avoid the universal try except. The universal try except is so bad that the website RealPython actually calls it the most diabolical Python anti-pattern. If you just use try except or try except exception, what you're basically doing is hiding all errors, even the ones that you don't know to expect. You're sweeping everything under the rug. So when the program fails or a bug is discovered, it makes it 10 times more difficult for you to find where that error occurs. In fact, you've also thrown away the helpful traceback that usually comes with an exception. Do you have any easy Python tips and tricks that you use to level up your PyFu? Share them in the comments below. I'd love to hear them. I hope this video has been useful to you. If you like it, please hit subscribe and click on the bell to get notified when future content releases.